They call them a wonderful sunny. You steal my breath. And emeralds from mountains, the rust towards the sky, never revealing their death. But tell me that we belong together. Dress it up with the trappings of love. I'll be captivated. I'll hang from your lips instead of the gallows of heartache that hang from above. And I'll be your crying shoulder. I'll be your love suicide. And I'll be better when I'm older. I'll be the greatest fan of your life. And the rain falls angry on the tin roof as we lie awake in my bed.
Welcome here on this beautiful, hot September day. We've had the coolest summer ever, and it's going to be 90 degrees today, of course. My name is Steve Franklin. I'm the pastor of Meridian UP Church, and I am honored to be here with Casey and Matt and with all of you as we gather in this celebration, this worship service. Today is a day that we celebrate what God has brought us here to do. And our scriptures remind us that God is love. And that those who abide in love abide also in God, and God abides in them. Today we gather here in the presence not only of this couple and all of you people, but in the presence of the Holy Spirit who has ordered and ordained this moment, a great day that it is. You see, not only is God present with us here this day, he has brought these two together as an expression of his love, and that is what marriage is, isn't it? A gift from God. And because it is his gift to us, it is to be taken seriously. We are to enter into it, not lightly, not taking it for granted, but with the promise that we will live out what he has blessed us with. You see, we're given this gift as a full expression of God's love for us, and it's shown in a husband and wife's love for each other. And so in this covenant that you two are about to make, you belong one another. You freely offer yourselves to each other. What an amazing picture of God's love for you. In marriage, you are called to a new way of life. You no longer live independently, but interdependently. Your lives are now joined together forever. And because of that, it is not something that we enter into lightly or carelessly, selfishly, but with thoughtfulness, commitment, and prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us, your children, and we ask this day that you would look favorably and mercifully upon Matt and Casey. They have come here today seeking your blessing. Let your spirit rest upon them so that with steadfast love they may honor the promises that they are about to make, and that they may do so in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. It is in his name that we pray. Amen. Matt, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed this covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire to enter into it?
I do.
And Casey, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed this covenant of marriage, do you also affirm your desire to enter into this covenant? Who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
Matt and Casey chose two scripture readings today for us to read. The first reading comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. Two are better than one, because they have good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him who is alone when he falls, and he has no one to lift him up again. And again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? And though a man might prevail against one who is alone, two will withstand him. So a threefold cord is not easily broken. Our gospel reading comes from 1 John chapter 4, verses 16 through 19. So we have come to know and to believe that the love of God that he has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God also abides in them. By this is love perfected. Perfected with us, so that we may have confidence for the day of judgment, because he also is in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not been perfected in love. We love because he first loved us. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You know, we come here today kind of expecting a fairy tale. It's what we're taught. It's what we're conditioned in our culture. Being married myself, I've seen more fairy tales and romantic comedies than I would like to admit. But it is a part of the world in which we live, isn't it? You see, we all dream of the day, the wedding day, because that's where the fairy tales end. Sorry to be a downer, but that's how the story usually goes, isn't it? The fairy tale ends and it says they live happily ever after and they fade off into the sunset and the cameras fade away. But what happens next? You see, there's a reason that the stories usually end at the fairy tales. It's because real life begins and real life is messy. You might be wondering why I started a sermon that way at a wedding, but it is because today real life begins, isn't it? You see, all of these movies and all of these stories end for us, and it gets to be a little ugly sometimes when life starts to work. You might be wondering where they got this guy to do a sermon on why love stinks sometimes, but it is our reality. So much is being made about marriage in our culture and in our world today. So many questions about why does it matter? Why is it important? Why should we come here? Why should we sit in the hot sun and put our hands over our eyes because we can't see, right? Why are we gathered here in this place to watch two people kind of make this promise to each other and then go off and have a party? What is it all for? What does it all mean? Yet Matt and Casey have decided to come here to this place to stand before you and before God to make a commitment to one another. And you're here to honor and to support them and to lift them up in their lives. You see, it is important. It is a special day. And it's not because any of you are here. Sorry. It's because what God is doing in their lives. You see, our story of faith tells us that God has created us as people to be in relationship with one another. That's who we are. It is who we are designed to be. Communal beings who live in relationship with one another, but anyone who's been married a long time or ever before will tell you sometimes being communal and in relationships is hard. But we desire it. It's in our DNA. It is who we are. And as we see the story of God unfold in our lives, we see that as part of who he created us to be. Constantly throughout the scriptures, we are being reminded of what these relationships are and why we have them. But for our relationships as people to have strength, God must be present there in the middle. When I was a kid, you ever see those kids walking around theme parks that have leashes on? That was me, by the way. I was a kid who loved to wander. It was just what I did. I have a large family. There were six of us, and I was the one who just saw something, and I just walked towards it without giving much thought to where I was going or what I was doing. Disney World, the fair, grocery store, it didn't matter. It came over the loudspeaker. Ken and Terry Franklin, your son Steve is waiting for you at ... fill in the blank. My mom, in order to correct this, leashed me. So now every time I see one of those kids, I laugh, but I'm allowed because that was me, right? But my mom had no other way to hold me together. She feared for me because I was prone to wander. You see, in our lives, We are all prone to wander one way or another, prone to move away from the center. And what we are doing here today and what marriage is when you tie yourself to God and to each other, He is pulling you back to the center, holding you back to where you belong. Have you ever wondered why we use the phrase at weddings, tying the knot? Well, the nerd in me did a little research, and that phrase came around in the 13th century because couples would literally come together and at their wedding tie a knot together. It would signify that two were becoming one. It seems a little weird and a little crazy in the world that we live in. How do two things become one? But when you really think about it, it's not that hard. Hydrogen and oxygen come together and they form water, right? That's how it works. What is happening here in this ceremony, what is happening between Matt and Casey today is that two lives are now one. They form a singular identity based in their belief that God is present in them. When Christ rules your hearts, you are called to be one body, one spirit, one identity. You see, in an age where marriages fail about as fast as they begin, the idea of God's intentions for marriage have been lost on many of us. But what binds you together today is not the commitment that you make. Sorry. That can easily be broken, and it's not the rings that you're going to share because they're just symbols. They're just signs. See, it's not the marriage certificate that I'm going to send back to the government either. What binds you together is your love for one another. And God's love for you. See, that's what we're taught. That leash that keeps pulling us back. Sorry, Matt, she's leashing you. She's bringing you down, right? But she's drawing you back and vice versa. Drawn together, tied together in the love of God. You see, marriage has failed. It's an inevitability of life. But your lives are brought together now forever. You can love each other because God first loved you. And over the years, the two of you will grow and life will change and things will happen that were not expected. It's been part of all of our stories, hasn't it? The challenge for you is not to avoid the change. It's not to avoid the growth. It is to go through it together. To hold on to that identity that is formed here this day. Through Christ and in your love for one another. You see, I know that I said that today is where the fairy tale ends, but it is also where the greatest story of your lives begin. It's the story from this day forward, how you live out this identity together as a couple, centered in Christ. And it doesn't mean that the road in front of you will be easy or without its challenges. What it does mean is that the two of you will go through it together. So, Casey, respect him. Show him each day that you love him and hold him up as the man that God has created him to be. And Matt, love her the way that Christ loved the church and gave up all that he was for her. See, the promises that you are about to make, they're not empty promises. They don't say that I will love you when it's easy, I will love you when you make me feel good about myself or when life is good. Say that you will love each other in the joys and sorrows and the highs and lows of life and the ups and downs. The promises that you are about to make will bind you together. In the end, you can love one another because God has shown you what true love is. So let the Spirit of God be your guide in your marriage. Let the sacrifice of Christ be your example for one another. And let the love of the Father be your envy. Enjoy the journey, both the highs and the lows, the goods and the bad, knowing that what God has brought together this day, not even you two can separate. Let your marriage be a blessing in which the two of you live out this call of Christ on your lives and the love of a Savior. Amen. Matt and Casey, since it's your intention to marry, join your right hands and with your promises, bind yourselves to each other. Husband and wife. Matt, repeat after me. I'm Matt.
Take you, Casey.
To be my wife. And I promise before God and these witnesses. To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Casey, repeat after me. I, Casey.
I, Casey.
Take you, Matt.
Take you, Matt.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And I promise.
And I promise.
For God and these witnesses.
For God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
Plenty and in want.
In
joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
What do you bring as a sign of your promises here today? You're in there, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
<I'm> both.
Let's pray. Almighty and gracious God, we give you thanks for what you are doing in the lives of these two who are gathered here before you this day. And by your blessing, may these rings be to Matt and Casey symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the covenant and the promise and the vows that they have just made. May these rings be a constant reminder not only of their love for one another, but your love for them. It's in Christ's name that we pray. Amen. Repeat after me. Casey.
Casey.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
It's a sign of our covenant.
It's a sign of our covenant.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Matt.
Got your
ring.
Matt. Matt.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our covenant.
As a sign of our covenant.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Forever could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way.
Almighty God, we give you thanks for this day that you have blessed this family with. We pray your blessing upon them as they go from this place, that they may live out what you have called them to do, that they may love one another, support one another, respect one another, that they may hear the call of Christ on their lives to be husband and wife in a way that honors you. Father God, we give you thanks for the blessings that you have bestowed upon them, and we pray your hand over them. Christ's name that we give you thanks and praise this day, as we join in the words that Jesus taught us to pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Before God and in the presence of this congregation and the people who are gathered here, Matt and Casey have made their solemn vow to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and the sharing of rings. And therefore, it is now my pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one separate. You may now kiss your bride. To Matt and Casey, as God's own, clothe yourself with compassion, with kindness, and with patience, forgiving each other as God has forgiven you, and crown all things with love, which binds them together in perfect harmony. And to the congregation, as we go from this place, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you, and may he look upon you with favor. As we go in the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the grace of the Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. It is now my distinct pleasure for the first time to present to you Casey and Matt Barnett.
Lucky to be coming home again. Ooh. They don't know how long it takes. Waiting for a love like this. Every time we say goodbye. I wish we had one more kiss. I'll wait for you. Lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. Lucky to be coming home again.
There's something tells me even if I could, I wouldn't change a thing. Picture in my head of 100 years from now, when all our lines have all been read, and we're both up there looking down, saying I wouldn't change a thing. It was perfectly imperfect, and every bit was worth it. And time wrapped around you like this ring. And something tells me even if I could, I wouldn't change a thing.
Dream of once in a love, love by
somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true. Oh, someday I wish upon a star, wake up.
Here's why, because I'm happy.
Clap along and give
finale. Can we get tickets to the next show?
Hell no.
For real?
Now that I'm a fly guy, and I fly high, wanna know why? Why I fly by? But yo, it's all good. Range Rover all wood. Do me like you should. Me good, me good. We be no stud. Shh. Wishing you was popping like we drug dealers, sipping Chrissy Bud Mackin. Honey in the club, me in the Benz, Icy Chris telling me to leave with you and your friends. So if Shorty wanna knock, we knockin' the diss. And if Shorty wanna rock, we rockin' the diss. And if Shorty wanna pop, we poppin' the Chris. Shorty wanna see the ice, then I ice the wrist. City talk.
Right foot, let's stomp. Left foot, let's stomp. Freeze! Everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like you never, never stop? Can you bring it to the top? One hop. Right foot now. Left foot now, y'all. Cha-cha, real smooth.
I'm up in here with some change to throw.
I'm so fancy.